The book of Ruth, let's go to the book of Ruth, chapter 1. If you look at that book, our today's message will become more real to you. Ruth, the whole of it, because we will be referring to different places, different chapters. But for now, let's read this one to go. Okay, give us NIV. Let's move on. Okay, let's jump to chapter 2 because of time. Restaurant, 1, 2, go. To underline that is very important. As it turned out, that means it was not naturally organized. It just turned out. It was not naturally organized. That's mean as it turned out. Let's move on. Are we reading Hindi? The one notice there is also important. Let's move on. Mm-hmm. Let's just stop there for time purposes. Bonus fear? What do I need my bonus fear? Bonus fear tena? Right. Now, as I prepared for today, this week, the Lord said that you should be told it is your time. Yeah, I know you are used to hearing power of things, but it is very important to catch what the Lord is saying per time. Can you look at somebody and tell them, God said, it is your time. Turn to somebody else and tell them your testimony. Tell them, God said, it is my time. Go to the third person and tell them, God said, not about you, about me. It is my time. If you look at what God is saying per time, you can know what He is preparing to do. Did you get that? If you catch what God is saying per time, is an indication of what He is preparing to do. We know what God is preparing to do, or we know the intentions of God by what He is saying per time. So, if God is saying it is your time, He has an intention to change things in your life. Can you say amen for that? Don't make me miss where I'm coming to preach this morning. Can you say a better amen? The intention of God is seen or known in His speaking. When He speaks, we know His intention. When God speaks, we know what He is planning to do. It is your time. It is our time. Wonderful Gobu, it is our time. It is our time for things to change. Now, I want to very quickly show you the picture of this story. A man, because of famine, goes to a land of Moabites, and after some time he dies. He has two sons. The sons also dies, and the wife is left with the two daughters-in-law. And we know the story. After some time, Naomi decided to go back to Bethlehem. And when she decided to go back, the Bible says that he talked to his daughters-in-law and told them, I am old now. I cannot get more sons to marry you. So go back to your people. One of them went, Ruth, the one this book is named after, followed to Bethlehem. And then both of them came to Bethlehem, according to the story. And when they came, the Bible shows us the story we have read. It is very important to know that when your time comes, there are things that God put into play. There are things God put into your emotion when your time comes. And I want you to start watching them carefully, because you will receive them. When your time comes for things to change, I want you to see why God wants to change the life of this woman. She has lost the husband. She has lost her home country. She has gone to a new place. She doesn't know what to expect. She knows nobody apart from Naomi. She is dealing with loss. Something needs to happen in her life for things to change. She is dealing with loss. She has lost the husband. She has not only lost the husband, she has lost her country. She has lost her people. She has lost,
I mean, it's like she is starting life again. It's like her life is starting afresh again. Because she is going to a place where nobody knows her, where she has nothing apart from the old woman. The only thing this young woman has is the old woman, the mother-in-law. Nothing else. Everything else is left in Moab. He just finished mourning the other day. The husband has died. And there are no children. So she has lost everything she had. So she comes into a new land. And God has an agenda to change her life. And I believe God is talking to you. Something is about to change in your life. I don't know where you are coming from. I don't know where you are now. But I believe I heard from the Lord that it is your time. It is our time for God to turn things around. If I were you, I would have said a better amen there. Look at somebody and tell them it's my time. Yeah. So when your time comes, there are certain things that God will put into motion. Number one, when your time comes, when your time comes, God will work from behind the scenes. God will arrange things when you are not even aware. It might appear like coincidence, but it's not a coincidence. It may look like good luck, but it is not good luck. God is working behind the scenes and he is pulling the strings together so that he may arrange things for you. Some of you sitting here this morning, I prophesy to you in the name of Jesus, before the end of this year, God will arrange something that will change the whole of your life. I declare divine arrangement that will remove this thing over here and move this thing over here and bring this person to you. He will be doing that behind the scenes so that he may favor your cause. Look at what the Bible is saying. Sit down. Chapter 2, verse 2. And Ruth the Moabite sent to Naomi, let me go to the fields. Not one field. That is to say, she did not have one particular one. She was just, according to her, she is just trying where she will be accepted. But she did not know that behind the scenes, God was arranging so that she is in the right field. Let me go to the field and then look at verse 3. So she went out and began to glean in the fields behind the harvesters. As it turned out, it was not arranged physically, but God arranged it from behind the scenes. I pray for you today that God will arrange things where you are not even seeing, where you even don't know what is happening. But things will just turn out that it was for you, that it was the right place, that it was the right people that God connected you to. It turned out she found herself. She did not organize. She did not prepare. It just turned out. It was arranged from behind the scenes. Before the close of this year, you will see what will be happening. Right now, as I'm talking to you, you may not see it, but God is working where you can't see. He is working behind the scenes to make sure that your things will change. When it is your time, God will work from behind the curtain. You are only seeing what is happening. You might think it is a coincidence. You may think it is good luck. But I came to remind you, it is not good luck. It is not coincidence. God is working behind the scenes. Yeah. Because it is your time. When it is your time, God will work behind the scenes so that things may begin to change for you. He will send people to you. They either don't know why they are looking for you. They either don't know your both names. But God is arranging things behind the scenes. Look at somebody and tell them, God is arranging things behind the scenes. Wait and see. When it is your time, it may look like coincidence. It may look like good luck. It may look accidental, but it is not accident. It is God working behind the scenes. It turned out she found herself working in a field belonging to the right person, belonging to the man who has the miracle for her, belonging to the man who is connected to her future, belonging to the man that will change her life, that will wipe her tears, that will take away her mourning. That is my prayer for you, that God will arrange things behind the scenes and connect you with somebody that has the ability to change your life, that has the ability to be a blessing to you, that has the ability to turn your life around. It is not accidental. It is divine arrangement. When it is your time, God will organize things where you are not seeing. Even as I'm talking to you right now, God is organizing behind the scenes. He is organizing some people to meet you. He is organizing some connections for you. He is organizing some helpers to come your way. Can somebody say amen for that? I'm saying, God, behind the scenes, you may not see it, but he is organizing. He is arranging. He is pushing this over here. I'm pushing this over here. I'm pushing this over here. And you will see what will come out of it. When it is your time, he will work behind the curtains, behind the scenes. He will just be pulling the strings. Do you know puppets? Have you seen puppets? The puppet master will sit behind, and all what he will be doing is just pulling the strings. And you will be seeing the puppet moving this way and moving this way and going down and going up, and you don't know what is happening. There is a puppet master behind the scenes that is pulling the strings. I declare over your life today, God is pulling the strings for the people that are supposed to come so that they may come. God is pulling the strings so that you may meet the people that will change your life. God is pulling the am I in the right church today? Look at someone and tell them, the master. Tell them like you mean it, the master is pulling the strings for you. Go to somebody else and tell them, the master is pulling the strings for you. It is your dance. It is your dance. It is your dance. When the puppet master begin to pull the strings, the puppet will not sing because it wants. It will sing the tune of the master. I declare in the name of Jesus, there are people who don't even like you. They will begin to sing your song because the master is pulling the strings. I'm pulling the strings. I'm pulling the... It is your time! It is your time. I'm not thinking. I know. I know it is your time. I know it is your time. I know it is our time. I don't care how long you have cried. The Lord told me to tell you it is your time. I don't care how long you have been struggling. The Lord told me to tell you it is your time. It is your time. The devil must hear he this. It is your time. The sorcerers must hear this. It is your time. The diviners must hear this. It is your time. Those who don't like you must hear this. It is your time. When your time comes, God will pull the strings here and there to make sure that all fall in their rightful places for your favor. Lift up your hand and say, it is my time. Shout it louder, it is my time. Shout it louder and scream it, it is my time. Wound up as Gobo, I came this morning under the unction of the Holy Ghost to announce to you, your time is now. Your time is not next year. Your time is not tomorrow. Your time for things to change is now. It is your time. It is your time. And when your time comes, the strings are pulling. The strings are pulling. The strings are pulling. He is pulling the strings when he is behind. It is not coincidental. It is not accident. It is not good luck. It is the puppet master that is pulling the strings, because it is. It is your time. How many people here believe that it is their time? Sit down. This young woman did not even know who is the owner of the field where she was going. She did not know. It just turned out. Did you underline that in your Bible? It just turned out that she found herself in the field of the right man. The man with a miracle. The man that will change her life. The man that will change her history. It just turned out. Am I talking to the right people? Yes. Are these the right people? Yes. It just turned out. She found herself. How can you find yourself? I thought people find you. How can you find yourself? It was divinely arranged. It is only when it is divinely arranged that you find yourself. In normal circumstances, people find you. Pastor Eric, these are your people. What do you think? Are you getting here? It just turned out. Some of you, before the close of this year, it will turn out that somebody you met 20 years ago, you just bumped at each other coincidentally. But it will not be coincidence. It will be God organizing things behind the scene. It just turned out. It turned out she found herself working in a field belonging to Boaz. The man that will change her life forever. The man that will wipe away her tears. The man that will make her forget her mourning. The man that will make her forget about her losses. It just stand out. Okay. Number two. When it is your time. I think I'm preaching better than you are receiving. Are you really getting what I'm preaching here? When it is your time. When it is your time. You begin to experience, but let me put it this way. You begin to experience divine notice. You begin to be noticed divinely. Let's go there quickly. Chapter 2, verse 4. Just then, God has not even finished arranging. She is still arranging, even the timing. Just when she appeared in the field of Boaz, just then, the miracle man appeared. No delays. The season you are getting into, there shall be no delays. There shall be no interruptions. Just the right time when she entered the field of Boaz, it is when Boaz was entering the field. Just then, Boaz arrived from Bethlehem and greeted the harvesters. The Lord be with you. Look at those greetings. I think we should begin those greetings. The Lord be with you. It's powerful greetings. The Lord be with you. The Lord bless you. Good greetings. Boaz asked the foreman, not anybody, the man in charge. He asked the man in charge of his harvesters, whose young woman is that? There were many women per se in that chapter, but it's only Ruth that was noticed. Who is that young woman? I'm telling you, before the close of this year, the right people will notice you. You will not be hidden any longer. You will no longer be governed by anything or by anyone. May the right people notice you. When Boaz, the miracle man, entered the field like this, the first person to notice was you. Oh, you missed it. You understand. I think it's only Pastor Nathan who got it. Maybe you got it. I said the miracle man has noticed you alone. He might not notice your neighbor. He might not notice who is sitting next to you. But he is here to notice you. Whose man is that? Who is that man? Who is that woman? Who is that pastor? There are many pastors, but who is that pastor? The moment he entered the field like this, there were many young women who were harvesting. Read that scripture, you will realize that. But the only woman that was noticed by the big man. You know, there are people who can notice you and nothing changes. That's why we are calling it divine notice. Somebody is being pushed by God to notice you. God will push somebody. They will see you even when they are closing their eyes. They will see you even when they sleep. They will see you in the dream. They will see you in the vision. I release the anointing for divine notice. May you be noticed by the right person. By the miracle man. By the person that carries what you need. Boaz, akuuliza makali yangi, aliuliza the right man. Did you get it? He asked the foreman, the man in charge. God will not let you to fall in the wrong hands. God, those people that are coming to help you, they will not ask the wrong people about you. They will ask the people that have a good testimony about you. Look at the testimony the foreman is giving about this young lady. The foreman, sit down. The foreman is not saying, oh, you know, this is just a woman. This is just a woman. She is actually a widow. She is even a foreigner. He is giving a good testimony about her. Good testimony. The foreman replies, she is the Moabite who came back from Moab with Naomi. Look at the connections he is bringing in. You know, Naomi was a powerful woman before she went to Moab. That's why she is telling them, don't call me Naomi anymore. Call me Mara, meaning bitterness. She says, I went full. I came empty. She was a powerful woman. The connection of Ruth to Naomi alone. Max. Eight Max. She said, please let me glean and gather. Oh, he is reporting. He's reporting what Ruth said to him. That means Ruth came and talked to the foreman. And she did not even talk about the big man. But the big man has noticed her. It is not campaigning that makes you to be noticed. May God notice you without campaign. May God cause people to notice you without campaign. Please let me glean and gather among the sheaves behind the harvesters. She went into the field and has worked steadily. She has worked very well. That's a good testimony. In other words, this young woman is not a lazy one. Yeah, she is not lazy. And it's the foreman who is giving her testimony. She has been working from morning. Steadily, from morning till now. Except for a short rest in the shelter. Short one. She did not take 3 hours to rest. So Boaz said to Ruth, my daughter, listen. She has even become my daughter. The first day she has become my daughter. That is what happens when you are noticed. When did she become my daughter? I mean, this is a Moabite woman. The man talking is a Jew. They even don't mix with Gentiles. How did she become? Notice. When God causes you to be noticed, a miracle can happen in 24 hours. I think here we will get my message. I'm speaking to you in the name of Jesus. That before the close of this year, God will cause you to be noticed. And there will be quick miracles. Quick interventions. Quick doors opening. The moment Boaz came to the field, there were many people in that field. Actually, to be particular, there were many young women in that field. But you see, a rich man doesn't know all the workers by name. So you can't say that Boaz knew all the girls that were working there, because they were hired not on monthly basis. They were hired when there is harvest. But there was something about Ruth. There's a mark that God put on Ruth to be noticed. It is coming upon you. That mark is coming to you. May there be a divine mark on you that will cause the right people to notice you. The right man, the miracle man, the man that carries what you need, the man that is ready to help you. May they notice you in the name of Jesus. When it is your time, God will cause you to be noticed by the right people. When it is your time. Some of you are very qualified, but nobody notices you. No matter how beautiful you are, if no man notices you, bonus fear. Am I saying something? It doesn't matter how beautiful you are. If there is no man noticing you, you stay unmarried. I'm saying the truth. Even if you are looking at me with suspicious eyes, it's true. You are very beautiful. You are qualified. You have even become a wife before you get married. But nobody notices you. And when nobody notices you, you begin to market yourself. Abadash. I'm saying something. Am I saying something? Look at somebody and tell them, after now, by force, they will notice you. Tell them the right people. I don't like the way you are talking this morning. Tell them the right people will notice you after now. Can you say amen for that? Lift up your hands and say, I receive my notice now. Say like you mean it, I receive my notice now. Let's say, from now, the right people will not pass by me. They will notice me. May the county officers notice you. May the national government notice you. I said, may the national government notice you. I said, may the national government notice you. May you be noticed by the right people. Notice simply means, look, Boaz did not look at her. Notice means looking with special attention. When Boaz looked at the field, he saw many girls, but he had special attention on one, called Ruth. People will not just look at you, they will look at you keenly. People will not just look at your documents, they will look at your document with attention. Attention, attention. May the attention of the right people turn on you. Woo! I think I'm preaching this morning. Okay, let me finish. Let me finish. I have 3-4 minutes. When it is your time, when it is your time, certain people will be working under divine orders. God will order some people. I said God will order some people. You will not even hear it, but you will be discussed when you are not there. You will be discussed in the right way. The right people will discuss you. And they will give orders. You cannot give orders unless you are in a position of authority. Look. Immediately after the woman was noticed, there was a crisis meeting. There was a crisis meeting immediately. And what orders did Boaz give? He told all the other stars, there is a woman coming from behind. Mukivuna mzivune kila kitu. Leave some things for her. Is another. I'm telling you, even where there is nothing, God will order something to be left for you. Even where they are carrying everything through corruption, through wickedness, through evil, God will give an order for something to be left for you. Some people will be working with orders by God for you. Maybe here is where I have the church. I said after now, there are some people, God will give them orders. Help that woman. Help that man. Help that man. Help that man. Promote that man. As she got up to clean, Boaz gave orders to his men. Not all men, his men. I wish I had more time. As she got up to glean, Boaz gave orders to his men. Even if she gathers among the sheaves, don't embarrass her. there is another to leave you alone. In other words, Boaz was saying, let her collect even what you have harvested. Leave her alone. No more harassment. And the Lord told me to tell somebody here, the season of harassment is over. No more harassment of any kind. No more harassment of any kind. God has given orders to be left alone. Leave that woman alone. Leave that man alone. Leave that girl alone.
Stay at 15.
As she got up to glean, Boaz gave orders.
What did he do?
He gave what?
The miracle man gave orders.
The owner of the field gave orders. The owner of the company gave orders. The owner, the landlord, the owner gave orders. Don't harass this woman.
Actually, he literally said, when you harvest, what you have ever harvested, some of it, drop it. Drop it for her. So that when she comes, she doesn't need to harvest.
God will, of course, give some people orders to make things easy for you. God will give some people orders to make adabakusha tapadaka. He will give orders so that your things will become easy.
There's a woman coming. So when you do harvesting, drop some wheat on purpose. There is somebody coming. Look at somebody and tell them, I'm coming. Look at someone and tell them, I'm coming. Even when they are talking about me, I'm still coming. Even when they are gossiping, I'm still coming. Even when the weather is contrary, I'm still coming. Look at somebody and tell them, keep coming. No, shake them like you will remove their shoulders and tell them, keep coming. Push them a little bit and tell them, keep coming, keep coming. I feel like preaching today. Boaz gave orders and he said, there is a woman coming. Do you know what I'm telling you as I close? You don't need to pat the back of anybody. Just keep coming. Let them talk, but keep coming. Let them lie about you, but keep coming. Let them gossip you, but keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. Keep coming. My time is up. Stand on your feet. Look at somebody and tell them it is your time. For real. And if there is a problem with English, tell them it is your time, ya ukweli. How many people believe it is their time? Yeah. I'm trying to tell you, I am God very clearly. It is our time.